Hi, this is Anne with SVG Cut File, and today I'm going to show you everything you need to know about resizing images in Cricut Design Space. All right, let's get started. Okay, so I'm going to open Cricut Design Space, and it'll bring us to this screen. I'm just going to resize the window a little bit, and then I'm going to go to New Project. Now I'll upload something. I'm going to use this emergency department technician graphic, so we'll insert that. And when it comes in, you'll see a highlighted area around everything. So right now this is grouped. I'll just put it up here. And to make this larger, we can just come down here to the bottom right corner of the highlighted area. Now if you're not seeing this blue stuff around here, you're probably not clicked on it. So just make sure you have it clicked. Then you can come right down here and increase the size like this. And you'll notice right here on the side and top, you can see how big it's making it. Right now, we can only resize proportionally, so we'll need to unlock it if we want to actually squish the design or make it super wide. So let's come over here to the lock button and unlock it. Now if we click on the bottom right, we can squish it really small or stretch it really wide. And I really don't recommend doing this because obviously it does not look that great. So I'm going to undo with Command Z or Control Z on a Mac, and we'll get back to the original here. Okay, so that is the most basic way to resize your graphics. I'm just going to delete this by hitting the delete key on my keyboard. And now I'm going to upload something with multiple parts like this alphabet here. So I'll click on this and insert images. And this one is all coming in together, all the pieces. Now this is kind of nice because you can separate these really easily. And so we'll do that first. I'm going to zoom out just a little bit. First, I'm going to ungroup. So I'll come up here to the right under layers and choose ungroup. I want the A, and I want maybe a J, and also the L. So I've got the three things that I want selected, although they're groups, we'll fix that in a minute. And I'm just going to hit Command X or Control X on a PC. So it cut them out and those are gone for now. Now we hit Command A or Control A to select all and delete it. And now we can just hit Command V or Control V to paste that stuff back in. Okay, I see I accidentally got the W, so I'll delete that. And now I'm going to move these up beside each other. Now I just want the first A, the middle J, and the last L, so I'm going to ungroup those two. And now we'll do the same thing. Select this, hold Shift and get the middle one, and hold Shift and get the last one. Command X or Control X, and then select the rest and just delete that one and paste. Looks like I still have this. It was group two, so I'll ungroup that and just delete that one. Okay, now all of these are perfectly sized as they are to work together. If I want to resize them, I need them to always be together like this. So to do that, I'll group them first, and then we can resize them to any size. Let me ungroup and move that L up a little bit. There we go. And then I'll group them again. So if you're working with a lot of different pieces, you'll want to click on them and then hold Shift and select them all. You can also do that over here in your layers. And then you'll want to resize them all at once because so many times they need to work together and you don't want one to be slightly larger than the others. Okay, let's delete that. I'm going to upload another design. Let's do this emergency room technician one. Now for this, this is coming in at 7.5 inches wide, and I want this to work on a t-shirt. And the thing about t-shirts is you want to have them be about 10 inches to 12 inches wide. And this also depends on the size of shirt you're going to put it on. But let's go ahead and resize this to 10 inches wide. Now we can manually do it like this, but we can also come up here to size and just type 10 and hit return. And it'll size it to exactly 10 inches wide and then proportionally to whatever it becomes. Now t-shirt sizing can be pretty tricky, but I plan to do another video all about t-shirt sizing. So look for that in the future. Another thing I wanted to mention about sizes here in Design Space is that each of these darker line squares make up 1 inch. So we can use that to resize our images. Let's say I wanted the height of these letters to be 1 inch. So I can just kind of keep an eye on the grid while I'm resizing this to make sure we get about 1 inch. Let me zoom out a little bit more. We're a little bit big now. Okay, and that looks really good. I'm gonna zoom in and see how close we got. Okay, so we're a little over 1 inch right now. We can just make it a little bit smaller and pull it down. And generally when you're doing this, it doesn't necessarily have to be exact, but it is nice to have those grid lines there to help you with sizing. One thing to keep in mind is that Cricut can only cut up to 11.5 inches because your machine will hold a 12-inch mat. But if you want to make something really huge, you can do that. It's just that you'll need to do it in pieces. And that's a whole nother video. So I hope this video has helped you with how to size things in Cricut. Okay, if you like this video and you want to see more videos like this, just hit the subscribe button and the little bell next to it and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.